number 12. You guys, today I am wearing pink lipstick. Hot pink lipstick. It's by Jeffree Star. It's called Prom Night, in case you were wondering. Because you guys are always like, what lipstick are you wearing? What are you wearing on your eyes? Like, what are you wearing on your face? So, yeah. It's Jeffree Star liquid lip or whatever. Prom Night. It's hot pink. But I'm just saying this because I feel like I haven't worn hot pink lips in forever. That was like my signature lip for so long, and lately I've just been doing, like, you know, really dark, like that Exorcism by Kat Von D and my red lipstick. So this is so weird for me. I mean, pink is my favorite color, but it's just so weird to wear it again. I'm like, oh my god, like, who is this? But guys, you know what time it is. It is time to open up our iThink calendar. So let's see what we got today. Oh, I'm like, what the heck is number 12? Let's hope that I can actually figure out what this is. Oh my god, I don't think I... Oh, it's a candle! It's a candle, 100%. I got that one. So today's story is a very creepy story. It's all about a girl that was left home alone. It's snowing outside, it's nighttime, and she sees something outside looking right back in at her, and it freaks her out. Now, I was actually gonna film this video outside because it snowed here last night. There's so much snow out there. I'll probably upload a video or pictures of the snow to, like, my Instagram and Twitter. So let's get right on into the story. So the girl in the story, her name is actually Brittany. And I know I made up the name for the characters in yesterday's story and I called them Brittany and Lauren. But today's story, like, her name's actually Brittany, so I'm like, ah! Her name is Brittany Snow, so that's like the actress, right? I actually met Brittany Snow years ago in New York City at Toys R Us. I met the whole cast of Hairspray, and she told me that she wanted to marry me. I think it's because she knew my name was also Brittany. It was so long ago, but she's like, I wanna marry you. So I was like, okay. So one night, Brittany was home alone. Her parents, they went out to some dinner party or something, and then Brittany just stayed home, and she was watching Netflix. She had, like, a blanket around her. It was freezing outside. It was snowing. She was kind of, like, watching the snow from time to time. And, you know, she was just having, like, a very chill night. So it was almost midnight, and Brittany was starting to feel a bit uneasy because her parents weren't home yet, and she didn't want to call them and be like, why aren't you guys home? She wanted to seem like, you know, a big kid because she was 16 years old, so she didn't want to, like, you know, seemed like a baby wanting her parents to come home, but she just felt very uneasy. So she started watching one of her favorite horror movies, and right beside her TV, there's this huge bay window, like, huge. So, you know, she's enjoying this movie, like, heck yes, I love horror movies, even though I'm scared right now because my parents aren't home, but I still love it. And she noticed something moving out of the corner of her eye through the bay window, the huge bay window. She was just kind of like, oh, like, that's kind of weird, what the heck's out there? So she was like, oh, whatever, you know, it's snowing outside, it could just been the snow that caught my eye or something. So she continued watching her movie until she saw the thing again moving. So she looked this time, like, she just, her attention was full out on this bay window, and she saw what it looked like to be a figure of a man coming towards the window. And the closer and closer he got to the window, she could actually make out his face, and, like, heck yes, it was a man, 100%. This man was so terrifying. His eyes were huge and just, he looked really crazy. He had this huge grin on his face. What is with these stories and people just like, ah, like this huge grin on their face? I don't get it, but that's what makes it scary, right? Like, you wouldn't stop staring at her with this huge smile. He had scars all over his face. Brittany had this blanket around her, so she, like, threw it over her head, thinking she could hide. Now, interrupt this, like, story for a second, but why do people think hiding under a blanket is gonna save you? Like, it's not gonna save you. I would never do that. If anything, that's even more terrifying because you just, like, blocked out your view of seeing, like, anybody. You know what I mean? Like, what if the guy just disappeared? Where did he go? Now, if you kept looking out the window and he just walked away, you would have known that he walked away. So then you would start thinking, like, did he teleport into my house or something? You know what I mean? I don't get the whole hiding under your blanket thing. I just don't. I don't get it. So a few minutes pass, or even like a few seconds pass, and Brittany, she is so scared, but she kind of peeks through her blanket. She looks at the window, the man is still standing there. He still, like, has this huge creepy smile looking, staring right at her, and he's right up against the window, and she just sees all the snow falling behind him. He would not go away. All of a sudden, he's reaching for his pocket, and he takes out, I should have had a giant knife for this, just to like, you know, you guys know how I like to do stuff like that. So he's reaching for his pocket, he pulls out a knife, and he's just holding it and looking at her. That terrified Brittany even more, so she pulled the blankets over her head. Again, like, girl, why? That's not gonna do anything. And she was hoping that the guy would just think it was a bunch of blankets on a couch. Like, he clearly saw you. That's why he's going after you. He's not just like peeking into the window because no one's home. He's peeking in because he wants you. So that is so scary. So just like take my advice, never hide under a blanket. I mean, maybe you shouldn't take my advice. I mean, maybe it comes in handy sometimes. I don't know the situation, but in this situation, like, girl, I mean, I guess I kind of understand, you know? I don't wanna be too mean. Well, I'm not being mean, but you know what I mean? I don't know. I've never been in this situation, so I get it. You'd be like terrified, but at the same time, he could disappear from the window, you know? And like, where did he go? And that's even more scary. I don't know. But anyway. So as Brittany is hiding under her blanket, she reaches for her cell phone and she starts calling 911. Smart girl. Brittany's heart was racing. Finally, when they answered and asked what her emergency was, she was whispering, saying, "There is a man outside my window staring at me with a huge knife. Please come quick." Soon as she hung up, she just, you know, sat there with a blanket over her because she was so scared. She was like, okay, I'm just gonna wait for the police to arrive. Everything will be fine. Finally, she heard the sirens outside of her house and she heard the police knocking at her door. So she like threw the blanket away and she ran to the front door and the police were there. She started explaining exactly what she saw. She said there was a man staring in from her bay window at her with a knife. And the police were saying there's no trace of anybody, there's no footprints. Brittany's like, what the heck? Yes, there was a man at that window. Like, pretend the bay, or maybe the bay window was there. Is that where I imagined it? She was like, yes, the bay window. Like, that's where he was. He was standing at that window, staring at me, grinning with a huge knife. Like, he wanted to kill me. When I was hiding under the blanket and I was peeking, he was still there looking at me. He was there. I saw him. I wouldn't be calling the police if nobody was standing there. I'm home alone also. Like, oh. So the police officers went to look outside of this bay window. There were no footprints. And Brittany was like, somebody was standing here. I saw him with my own two eyes. The police officer's like, girlfriend, you've been home alone. Have you been watching like scary movies? And you know, Brittany was watching a horror movie. And Brittany's like, no, maybe I was, but I saw somebody at this window looking at me and he had a knife. Like, I swear to you, I swear on my life, he was standing there. Like, you can't tell me he wasn't there. And the police were trying to say, like, well, there's no footprints. I mean, this is new snow. There's, you know, the snow's been here. There's no footprints to indicate that anyone's been standing there. Now, guys, this is when it gets, like, woo! Scary AF. So, the police officer, you know, they're trying to calm down Brittany, like, you know, trying to come up with some explanation because they think that she really just saw something, like, you know, in her imagination. So they kind of like were playing around with the couch and like moving it and stuff, just kind of like, you know what I mean? Then the carpet right behind the couch, they saw two footprints, wet footprints, and a knife on the carpet. The police officers were in complete shock and they said to Brittany, like, you did not see a man outside your bay window. You saw his reflection inside your house, standing right behind you the whole time. Now, guys, I know everyone's gonna say, well, then what happened? Did they capture him? I don't know. I don't write these stories, you know? I find them and I share them with you guys. Some of you guys request stuff to me and I do it. I don't know, because people sometimes get mad, like, what happened? Why didn't you say what happened? I don't know. Whatever I tell you guys is all I know in my videos. I never just like leave something out, you know? So I'm assuming he was caught, you know? So can you guys imagine that happening to you? That is so traumatizing. I hope they captured the guy. I guess, you know, the story kind of ends there because it's just, you know, it's so creepy. But you guys remember the movie When a Stranger Calls? Remember when the phone call is coming from inside the house and then all that dramatic music starts? That is the most terrifying thing. And what did, remember she's on the phone with the guy? What did he say? She's like, what do you want from me? Let me get my phone out. What do you want from me? Leave me alone. Or I don't know, right? I want you, your blood, all over me. What did he say? Something like that, right? I've always wanted to be in a horror movie. What do you want from me? I mean, I don't know. I don't know. I need some acting glasses. But anyways, that movie is so terrifying. But, whoa, I got chills right now. I just remember that dramatic music after he's like, your blood, all over me. Or when they said, the phone call is coming from inside the house. Get out of there now. Or I don't know, something like that. So anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the story. It is so creepy, but you know, That's why I'm all white today, because you know, it's all about like the snow outside, and there's snow outside here. I'm so excited, so I don't know, maybe I already posted a video or pictures or something, but if you want to see the snow, head over to my Instagram at birdie44. It's probably in my story, I don't know, or my profile, like girl, I don't know. But anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. As always, you rock my world, and the song lyrics, Michael Jackson. Hashtag team Britney44, hashtag Barillarins. Hey, I am uploading every single day this month, so make sure you guys are subscribed if you haven't subscribed yet. Turn on your notifications so you'll be notified every single time that I upload a video. We are counting down until Christmas together. 25 days of uploads. I am super excited, so, but anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow for Merry Britmas, day number 13. And tomorrow, since it's day number 13, and that's like a creepy number, right? I have a very awesome video for you guys. I am so excited. I'm filming it tonight, and it's something that a lot of you have been wanting me to do. I'm kind of nervous, but I'm so excited. So stay tuned for that tomorrow. This will be a sneak or a hint. If that gives any hint. Viewers beware, you're in for a scare.